Hello again, Tim Spector here of the ZOE Symptom Study app, giving you some updates on progress. And it's been an interesting week. Plenty to discuss in the media about going on holiday, not going on holiday, not booking, worrying about new variants, changing the whole game, and a lot of anxiety and confusion. So what I want to do is really talk about what we do know about, which are the facts at the moment, and see if we can draw some projections from them. Data show that we have 14,000 new daily infections, which is 80% down on where we were at our peak on the 1st of January. So rates have been falling steadily for over 5 weeks now, and that's fantastic. And that's probably a combination of the vaccine rollout and the restrictions that are in place and the people aren't moving around. The data show that there are still around 280,000 people with symptomatic COVID floating around in the population. Majority, the highest region with them is still London, but that's coming down. And this means that about one in 240 people is currently suffering from the virus, and you're likely, you may bump into them or have them in your home. As I said, all regions are dropping. There are a few counties that are bucking the trend, and at least temporarily, and Herefordshire, Gloucestershire, Bedfordshire are some of them. So it's possible that in some of your regions you're not seeing these dramatic changes, but hopefully that will just be temporary. How's the NHS doing, which is the other parameter that the government are using to say when we can come out of lockdown? Well, they still are stretched and feeling the strain of so many months of hard work. But admissions are down 60% from the peak on January the 11th. And hospital capacity, that's the percentage of the total beds that are occupied by COVID, has come down about 50% and ranges from 14% in the southwest to 32% in London. So still lots of patients in hospital, but again, the trends are in the right direction. Deaths are still too high. We don't really understand why that is. Still over 1,000, and we have a high death rate compared to other countries that isn't falling as fast as the other parameters. But given that we've now vaccinated most people in those high-risk groups, that should start to fall fairly rapidly next week. The vaccine program, as you might have heard from my Monday video, is going very well. Over 12 million people vaccinated, and that's 20% of the population having had one dose. Now, we thought one dose wasn't going to be quite enough, but our data are reassuring that it's pretty good, and that after 3 weeks you're getting 67% protection. That's our analysing over 45,000 of you who've given us the data and have had a long time to report whether you're getting new COVID or not. What about the future? Well, if the current excellent trends continue, we can make some broad projections for the future based on the assumptions that everything is going ahead and the R value will stay the same at 0.8, which means that number of cases will be halving every 2 weeks. This means that by the time the government makes its decision about opening up in March, in 2 weeks' time, rates should be down to 7,500 in 2 weeks' time, and 3,500 by March the 8th, when they're thinking of reopening schools and universities. Those levels are the ones we saw at the end of May and beginning of June if you can remember that far back. And we should be seeing by then rates in the population of less than 1 in 500. So I think they will be conditions that will allow us to reduce some of these restrictions, get people back to school, university, and also hopefully outdoors more where people can exercise and socialize safely. So my final word is that do log your vaccines with us. And if you have been vaccinated, do remember that those first 2 weeks you have no protection at all. And many of the symptoms of the vaccine, like fever and headache, can resemble COVID. So with our app, you can get a test with any unusual symptom. And there's plenty of unusual symptoms out there at the moment, plenty of COVID. So be safe, get a test, and keep logging. Thank you.